Hello guys, this is your boy Ken Swinger and welcome back to my YouTube channel. And if it's your first time here and you are looking to improve as a Forex trader, I recommend you liking this video, subscribing to the channel, turn on the bell notification so whenever I post educative content like this, you will be notified as fast as possible. And in this video, I want to talk about one of the most important aspects of Forex trading, and that is how you can backtest your Forex trading strategy. Let's roll. Welcome back guys. Before we dive deep into this topic, I recommend you stick to the end of this video, because by the end of this video I will be showing you how I personally backtest my Forex trading strategy. So let's first start by explaining what backtesting simply means. Backtesting simply means going back to historical data to test and see how effective and accurate your Forex trading strategy is. After you are done learning your strategy, for you to be able to trade with it effectively and on a consistent basis, you have to make sure you have backtested your strategy for several months so that it will be ingrained in your subconscious mind, and whenever you're on the live market, you'll be able to trade with it effectively. One of the most important things about backtesting is backtesting helps you to gain confidence in your system. When you continue to backtest your strategy, you begin to see how accurate and effective your Forex strategy giving you confidence on how and when to apply them. The second thing I also want to talk about is backtesting also helps you for you to be able to identify your high, your medium and low probability setups. This is a very important point, guys. If you're able to identify your high, your medium and low probability setups, you will be able to know when or the time that you have to go all in the market and the time that you have to minimize your risks whenever you're entering a trade. So backtesting is a very important point, guys. It's a process that no trader, all the Forex gurus that you see out there, no one skipped backtesting. So if you want to be consistent in your trading, make sure you backtest your Forex trading strategy several months so that you'll be able to trade with it effectively. And before we dive deep to my screen so I show you how I personally backtest my Forex trading strategy, one thing I also like to put across is make sure you backtest one pair for a very long time before you move on to another pair. Don't just backtest once or twice and think you are done, you're moving to a different pair. You have to make sure you master one pair at a time. So assuming you are backtesting EURUSD, make sure you backtest your Forex trading strategy on EURUSD several times and understand everything that you need to understand before you move on to another pair. So without wasting my time, let's dive straight to my screen and I'll show you how I personally backtest my Forex trading strategy. Let's go.
Welcome to my screen, guys. This is Trading View, and if you don't know Trading View, this is the website I use for my analysis and also my backtesting. I get all the pairs, all the metals, all the indices that I want to trade. I get everything on Trading View. So if you also want to sign up for Trading View, I'll leave the link in the description below. You can also go sign up with them for you to get a $30 bonus. That is if you sign up with the link I'll leave in the description below. We are currently on EURUSD, and for you to also use the backtesting feature on TradingView, you have to sign up for their monthly subscription. It's not expensive at all. It's as low as $14, I believe, you can all afford, so you can get access to the backtesting feature. And for the sake of this video, I want us to start the backtesting from 2018. We can backtest at least 4 months or 5 months of 2018. Then I'll show you how I backtest my Forex trading strategy. And before I start backtesting my Forex trading strategy, what I do is I document them. I don't just use the replay to go back to time and just be testing my strategies. Yeah, that is how I do it. But I document them so that when I'm free, I can review the backtesting I did on that particular pair and see how the trades look like, how I entered, and what I saw before I made that entry, so that I can reinforce everything in my mind. So you can use the Microsoft Word, anything that you feel comfortable. Let's keep it simple. I think I've saved some as PDF. You can see 2018 AUD SGD backtesting. You can see I made some backtesting right here. I documented everything down, how the trade was going, documented everything, and also used the Microsoft Excel. You see, shots, this is screenshots, green, shots, this screenshot of the trade, green, shots, screenshots, loose, shots, screenshots, break even. So I document every backtesting that I do. I recommend everything. So it's just like you're in the live market and you are journaling your trade that you take. I hope I'm making sense. So make sure you also implement that in your backtesting. So the button that you have to click on trading view, if you don't know, let me show you real quick before you get into the back testing. This is the bar replay tool. And I said, if you want to get used to the, if you want to get access to the bar replay tool, you have to make sure you subscribe to the monthly subscription, which is not expensive at all. It's as low as $14. So when you click on it, you have this red line appearing, this red vertical line appear on the screen, and you can just start, you know, clean charts from where you want to start. So if you want to start from 2018 or 2019, whatever year that you want to start backtesting, you just use your vertical line that will appear after you click on the bar replay tool, and just clean from there, and you can start backtesting. It's as easy as that. I hope I'm making sense. So like I said, I wanted to start this backtesting from 2018. I'm backtesting some few months, at least 5 months of 5 months of 2018. Then you will see how I backtest and also implement this into your trading. So you are currently on January 1st, 2018. Nice. So I just cleaned the chart. You can see right now you are currently on January 1st, 2018. So I said I want to backtest 5 months of 2018. So after cleaning the charts, after using the bar replay to clean the charts, what I do is I drop on my lower time frames, then I start to spot my trading opportunity. I start to play the chart and see if I'm in the live market and apply my trading plan and see how effective it is. So just stay tuned and see how I do it. Alright guys, so I just finished executing one trade for which you guys can see it went successfully. And let me just make a quick discussion on the trade before I continue the back testing. So let me quickly move on to the weekly time frame, show you what I saw on the weekly time frame before taking decision on this trade right here. My internet is quite slow. I don't know what is going on, but I believe it will come very soon. Then I will show you guys what I saw and how I executed this. So on the weekly time frame, things was quite clear and simple. On the weekly time frame, we have a market that has that impulsed all the way up to the upside and retraced all the way back to this previous level that got broken impulsively. And when immediately I saw price retracing to this point, I realized price was just, you know, retracing to test this key level, and that was also the level that was perfectly aligning with structure on the Fibonacci, on the golden Fibonacci level, that is the 0.618 Fib level. And one of the things that also made me get more confirmation on this setup was, you can see immediately price went up and made this kind of formation and retested to this zone. I knew price was about to form some kind of inverse head and shoulder pattern. This is what inverse head and shoulder pattern looks like. And one of the triggers that I use to identify or to spot patterns easily is, so I switch to my line chart, and clearly you can see this inverse head and shoulder pattern that is currently playing out here on the weekly time frame. So after spotting this pattern on the weekly time frame, I drop down to my daily time frame. And after dropping down to my daily time frame, I saw this double bottom confirmation, or I saw this W formation. And this W formation, I've been talking about this W formation almost all the time to those who are in the Trader Classroom community. If you're not part of Trader Classroom community, please, it's a fast growing community where you get to meet like-minded forex traders. Then you get to make friends and make a lot of discussions, and you get to learn a lot there. So I also leave a link in the description below so you can also join the community. So on the daily time frame, I saw a double top, or some will call it double top. Some will call it double bottom. Some will also call it double formation. You can see, like I said, whenever I say double formation and the market impulse up, my next move is I'm waiting for price to retrace to the neckline. Then I'll look to, I'll look for a buying opportunity all the way to the to the upside. And clearly, that is what happened on the daily time frame. You can see this. W formation formed, a retest to the neckline, and price exploded to the upside. So when I saw this on a daily time frame, I saw price retesting. What I did was I just went straight to the 4-hour time frame, and then took my entry right on the retest of the neckline. And you can see how price exploded to my take profit. You can see I got how many I was able to bank, like 181 pip on this trade, which is a very, you know, good trade. And one of the takeaways we can, one of the things I learned from this trade is, you can see immediately I got triggered, price impulse all the way down, giving me some deep drawdown. And you can see this is some of the things backtesting will teach you. It will teach you how to get a good trade management skill to improve how you manage your trade and how you are patient on your trade. And if you don't backtest, this kind of a deep impulse or drawdown can just scare you, and you just close your position thinking it's not going to work, and it will just come back impulsing all the way to the upside. So you can see a lot of emotions that actually went on around this drawdown area. So backtesting is really important, guys. So let's just continue on to backtest, then I'll continue to show you the process and how I do it. And before I move on to the next before I continue to the backtesting, what I do is, like I said earlier on, I backtest, I document everything. I don't just continue playing, but for the sake of this video, backtesting and how I'll be documenting it is going to take a lot of time. So whilst I'm backtesting, like, immediately I'm done taking one trade, I'll go to my Word or my Excel, document it. If it's a win or loss, how I backtest, what I learned from the trade, I document everything down. So I hope we don't forget that. Let's continue. Yeah, guys, so I just finished off with another trade that I just took. Again, I didn't go far before getting another trading opportunity, and it was just also a very simple trade that I just took, not a very difficult, it was a no-brainer trade that I just took. So let me just also explain that, you know, after taking the first trade, price started retracing and coming all the way down to test this key level of resistance that got broken and possibly to the upside. And also, when you take your Fibonacci to measure the impulse all the way to the upside, you can see that price came all the way down to a test to a golden Fibonacci level. You can see the 0.618 Fibonacci level. That is the level that price came all the way down to test that level. And immediately price tested that level, I knew that price was about to reverse, because from here I was able to identify the trend from here. I was able to identify the trend from this point. So from here going, I know the price is in a clear uptrend. So I don't look to, or I don't intend trading against the trend. So after seeing this retest on the reverse resistance and also a retest to the golden Fibonacci level, I came straight to the 4-hour time frame. And also, you can see clearly, I told you earlier on, this same concept keep on appearing. Let me switch to the line chart and I'll show you the concept. You can see this W formation. And immediately it's formed, it came all the way to test the neckline and exploded to the upside. So that's the same thing I'll use for my entry on the 4-hour. You can see price tested on the neckline. You can see right there, I took my entry right on the neckline and price exploded to the upside. I got like 212 pip on this trade. You can see how amazing and how confident I feel with my strategy right now. You can see how happy I am backtesting my strategy and getting this kind of wins. I know I'm very happy, and I'm not expecting to get continuous wins, but I'm expecting that at the end of the backtesting, I'll still come out to be a consistent winner. So let's continue backtesting. Yeah, guys, so I currently took a loss on one of my trade. Let me just explain to you. I didn't change anything. I just use the same procedures that I use whenever I'm trading, and I got a loss. So it's just part of the game. Like I said, I'm not always looking out to get a consistent wins in this backtesting, but I also want to see my number of losses and the number of wins that I get in a particular month, or I'll measure my progress whilst I'm backtesting. So clearly what I saw on the daily time frame was the market coming down to test this strong level of support that has been rejecting off several times right here. And after price testing this strong level of support, price formed something like an inverse W formation. As you can see, this is like an inverse W formation. Price went all the way up, came all the way down to test the neckline. So expecting price from here to push all the way up to form a higher high or move above the previous high. So I went straight to my 4-hour time frame. Wanted to take. I took this trade right on the retest of this previous level that got broken on the 4-hour. Price triggered, went into profit, and came all the way back, taking me out on a loss. So guys, you see how backtesting really goes. I've incurred right now currently with this three trades that I've taken so far, I've gotten two wins and also one loss. Which if I'm going according to good risk management, I'm still coming out on top. So let me just go through it one last trade before I end the session. Yeah, guys, so I just executed another trade, and as you can see clearly, the trade just went to hit my take profit nicely and beautifully. And let me just also take you through a quick breakdown on what I saw on the higher time frame before taking this trade, so that I can end the session right here. So clearly on the daily time frame, my internet is very slow this time. I don't know what is going on right now, but let me just explain. So on the daily time frame, clearly you can see the market forming on a W formation right here, and the market came all the way to retest to the neckline. I've already spoken about this in the earlier trades that I took. Whenever you see W formation, you're expecting the market to make a retest to the neckline, the market will explode all the way to the upside. So immediately I saw price forming this kind of W formation and also retesting right here. I knew that price from here, there's a high possibility that price will shoot up from here. So I went on a 4-hour. And also when you go on the daily time frame, what we can also see on the daily time frame is the market had also retest straightly to a 0.5 Fibonacci level, which made it a high confirmation trade for us to take on our 4-hour time frame. So if you have studied how I make my analysis, I use the high time frame, that is the monthly, weekly, daily for direction, and I use the 4-hour strictly for my entry. So when I go on the 4-hour, I'm just going from my trading view, it's kind of lagging right now. See, it just deleted. But as you can see, let me go back again and see if it will work. My trading view is fucking up right now. Yes, so I took my entry right on the retest of the neckline, and you can see price exploded all the way to the upside. And one thing that you can also take away from this particular trade, or I learned from this particular backtesting trade I took, is you can see our price consolidated around this zone. Where's my brush tool? You can see our price was consolidating around this zone. And these are all things that might scare retail traders out of their trade, and they will just leave a high probability trade without not even knowing why they left, because markets were consolidating. They were afraid to give all the profit back into the market. But in some cases, the market might drop or anything of that sort. But with backtesting, you realize that you need to be patient. For me, immediately price moved into profit, and I moved my stop loss to at least one people or two people into profit. That is all. I allow my trades to run. I don't trade stops. I don't do anything of that sort. I just allow my trades to do what? To run. And the disadvantages sometimes can go up and come all the way down to hit you and take you out on a break even. And when the advantage is, you always, your take profits always get to hit. And that is one of the nicest things about how I trade. So let's review the number of trades I've taken so far. I said we're going over 5 months of trades, but it seems we are around September there, but no problem. It's because I wasn't getting any trading opportunity. That is why I went all the way back. You see, from here I missed this move down because I didn't get any clear confirmation that price was about to move down. Even though it was trending down, I didn't get any chance to enter because of how I trade. And you know, I was sticking strictly to my strategy. I didn't think that, oh, because there's this, because I trade this, but even there's this opportunity. You have to be disciplined, okay? Follow your trading plan. And before you even start backtesting, make sure that you have your trading plan in front of you. Then you follow it strictly. You don't do anything else, okay? Especially when you're starting, have your trading plan in front of you so you know exactly what you're looking for on the market, so you won't do anything else. So from this trades that I took how many trades? I took 4 trades, and 4 trades, I was profitable in 3 trades, and I got 1 loss. So you can see out of 4 trades I took, I lost 1 and got 3 wins. So you can see how effective my strategy is for me, and that's a strategy that I still use up to this time. So you can see how I backtest my first trading strategy. And whilst I'm backtesting too, I'm also doing what? I'm also documenting everything down. I didn't just do this backtest and just leave it just like that. I document everything down so that after backtesting and after doing everything, I'll just go back to the backtesting documentation, go through and see the mistakes I did or what I learned from the trade and what I can also implement as times goes on. So I hope you have learned something from this video. Remember to leave a comment below. If you don't understand anything, just remember to comment below. If you have just any additional contribution, just leave it in the comments below and I'll reply as soon as possible.
If you've been able to make it to the end of this video, I recommend you liking this video, subscribing to the channel, and turn on the bell notification so whenever I post educative content like this, you will be notified, and also to support the channel. See you in the next one.